we are talking about Sha'ban, etiquette of a Muslim in the month of Sha'ban. Now let's understand what a Muslim should be doing in the month of Sha'ban before entering into Ramadan. There are plenty of things which I have got from the information from the Ahadith that a Muslim should be very, very careful and serious about the month of Sha'ban before he is serious about Ramadan. The first point that we have to remember, that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to fast the month of Sha'ban, and he has advised the Sahaba even to, you know, fast in the month of Sha'ban. And the Sahaba also have understood from their way of celebrating the month of, or you know, practicing in the month of Sha'ban, that the days which they have missed in the previous Ramadan, which is Fard Ramadan, Fard fasting, if those days, if they have missed due to any reason, they could be ill, they could be travelers, or women in impurities in the menstrual cycles, or due to any other genuine reason where they were unable to fast in the last Ramadan, then this is the last opportunity given to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they should make them up in this month before entering into Ramadan. So it could be any day in the whole month of Ramadan, they can make their fastings. If it is 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, they can, you know, decide when they want to do it, but it should be done before starting of Ramadan. So this is the first thing. And we know from the Ahadith of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ that the women of Rasulullah ﷺ would say that we would make up our days, missed days of previous Ramadan due to the menstrual cycle, we could make them up in the month of Sha'ban. So this is the Hadith, and there are lots of evidences are there. It is mentioned in 7 or 8 books of Ahadith. I'll just name the books of Ahadith and inshallah move to the next point. It is mentioned in Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, Nasai, Abu Dawud, Ibn Majah, Musnad Imam Ahmad, and also in Mutta Imam Malik, and different books of Ahadith. So these are 8 famous books of the Hadith that we normally learn. So this Hadith says that a person should make his missed days in this. This is the last opportunity for him to make. Second issue, there are people that they had some days to be covered and they had to fast some of the days, but they are dead now. Okay, some of your family members, maybe uncle, auntie, father, mother, or young person, young woman, who had some days to make up, and they are not there today, and they had to make them up. So Rasul ﷺ has said, "Man mata wa alayhi sawmun aw siyamun, falyasum anhu waliyuhu." If somebody has died, and he has to or she had to make up the days, then the relatives, the closest relatives, should fast on that person's behalf. So this is again a second opportunity for us, that if we know that somebody in our family who died. So a woman came to Rasulullah and she said, "Ya Rasulullah, my mother, when she died, she vowed some of the days to fast, but she could not make it. And she died. Now what's the ruling about it in our religion?" Then Rasulullah has said that, "What is if your mother died with the debt on her head? Won't you give back that debt, clear the debt?" She said, "Yes." Then Rasulullah said, "That is the debt between the humans, and this is the debt between you and Allah. So your mother has to clear the debt of Allah, so you have to fast." So this is again very clear that if a person had died, and he or she had something to make up, and anybody of you know it, then you can fast on that person's behalf. If you cannot fast, then the second option is that if you remember that somebody died and it had 4 days, for an example, or 3 days, or 1 day, any day, any number of days, then for 1 day, you have to feed one person one meal. One day, one person, one meal, which can be like £3 meal, £5 meal, whatever it is. But for one day, it is one meal for the days that they have to make. So if it is 5 days, 5 meals. It can be 5 different people at one time, or can be one person, but at 5 different occasions you can feed that person. So that will be taken off, the debt will be taken off from that person's head. So this is the second issue. If somebody had to fast some missed days due to any reason, he or she died and couldn't do it, and you know it, then these are the two options. Either you fast, or you can pay fidya on that behalf, on the behalf of that person.